Welcome, welcome, dear student. In one another session, myself, Mrs. Darshana Sandeep Shinde from KKWIUP Chandori. Today we deal with the chemotherapy of protozoal diseases. In that we see the chemotherapy of malaria. Let's start the session. Learning outcomes of our today's session. After watching this video, students are able to understand and recognize what is meant by chemotherapy of malaria. Life cycle of malaria protozoa, drugs producing casual prophylaxis, suppressive drugs, prophylactic measures in the malaria, drug producing radical cure, adverse reactions. Then we see the chemotherapy of malaria. Malaria is an infectious disease of the worldwide distribution caused by the protozoa of the genus Plasmodium. It is caused by the protozoa of the genus Plasmodium, which is transmitted from the man to man by the bite of the female Anopheles mosquito. A causative agent is of all Plasmodium species. Protozoa parasite, it has a 4 species infecting to the humans. First is a Plasmodium falciparum. Plasmodium falciparum causes the more serious malignant ternant or subternant malaria. Then Plasmodium vivax causes the benign tartan malaria, in which fever occurs every 48 hours. Then Plasmodium malariae is responsible for the rare quartan malaria, in which fever occurs every 72 hours. Then Plasmodium ovale or ovili, it is characterized by the chills, high fever, anemia and sweating. All 4 types of Plasmodium species responsible to cause the malaria. Then we see the life cycle of the malaria protozoa. See, this is the life cycle of the malaria protozoa. It is mainly involved in the liver. Whenever the infected female Anopheles mosquito bites malaria patient and carry the these protozoa into her blood. When it bite to the healthy person, it may be reaches to the liver. In liver, where is the hepatic zones are forms, it is a in liver there is a production of the RBC. That sporocytes are involved in the erythropoiesis process, and hepatic scissors are formed. Then in this hepatic scissors, these sporocytes of this and Plasmodium are also included. Then these scissors are break or burst or rupture, and this is known as the erythrocytic stage. And from that, these scissors are entered into the RBC, and these are goes into the or they are entered into the RBC. Whether they develop, whether they form the colonies and rupture again, and then they are going to into the bloodstream, or some scissors are going along with the these RBCs and get it contacted with the all blood and infect to the all blood, and in that blood they form the gametocytes or gametocytes, and these gametocytes are sucked by the other female Anopheles mosquito, and which is responsible for transfer of the malaria. If it is not, it is sucked by the other bacteria or other species of the mosquito or the male Anopheles mosquito, the malaria cannot be or malaria cannot be transferred from one male to another. Only the Anopheles mosquito, female of the Anopheles mosquito, is responsible for it. We see that what are the different drugs which are preferred in all these malaria. In erythrocytic stage, progranil is a very important one. or it may be suggested in this erythrocytic stage. Then the next, after the erythrocytic stage, quinine, chloroquine and mercaprine, these type of the drugs are used as a suppressive therapy. And primaquine or pamaquine, whenever the gametes are formed into the blood at this stage, these pamaquine or primaquine are used. All the drugs are specified in their specific action in only that phase only. We see the drug used in malaria. Anti-malarial therapy has main aims like prophylaxis, suppression and the radical cure. The action of an malaria drug may be most effective at the one stage or other stage during the life cycle of the parasite. A strict division is not possible, but it is helpful to group drugs according to their predominant use. That's why the drugs can be classified according to the drugs producing casual prophylaxis, suppressive drugs which do the suppressive action, and drug producing the radical cure. First of all, we see the drugs producing the casual prophylaxis. These drugs aims to prevent the infection after the bite of an infected mosquito. Whenever infected mosquito bite, it gives the prophylactic treatment. A true casual prophylactic would kill the sporocytes in the bloodstream of the human host before to start the pre-erythrocytic stage. Before they go into the pre-erythrocytic stage, this prophylactic drug can kill these sporocytes. Then no drug is at present dose. This is, but it is responsible to eliminate the parasite during the pre-erythrocytic stage. This prophylactic treatment is only useful for the to eliminate the parasite from this pre-erythrocytic stage. This drug could be called as the called as a tissue schizontocytes. Schizontocytes means they are kill the that schizontocytes. Then for the pre-erythrocytic stage, progranil is used. This is the bigonides and may be taken as orally. It is completely absorbed but rapidly excreted. It is metabolized in the body to an active form which is probably suppress the nucleic acid synthesis in the malarial parasite, and by prevailing of its phenolic acid. This effect is enhanced by giving the sulfonamide at the same time. Then the progranil is very effective against the pre-erythrocytic stage of the Plasmodium falciparum, though less effective against the Plasmodium vivax. That is, progranil is effective against the Plasmodium falciparum. It has no direct action on the gametocytes, but if carried over into the mosquito, will prevent the development of sporocyte and thus prevent the mosquito becoming infected and spreading the disease. Whenever we give the progranil, it will no action on the gametocytes if gametocytes are formed. But if it will be helpful to prevent the spreading of the malaria, because whenever the anopheles female is bite to the infected person and we give the progranil to that patient, it is not spreading to the another person one. Progranil is effective in the acute attack of the malaria, but it is slow in action, and other drugs such as the chloroquine are preferable. Then we see the prophylactic measures in the malaria. What kind of prophylactic measures we can take? It is advisable for all those entering for living in areas where the malaria is endemic to take the prophylactic measures, which include the avoidance of the mosquito. That is, we use the sleeping nets as well as the taking of the drugs, prophylactic drugs. Both progranil and pyrimethamine may be used as the prophylactic drug, though they provoke the emergence of resistance strains. Then, pyrimethamine is slowly excreted and needs to be taken only weekly when used as a prophylactic. But proganil must taken daily. Pyrimethamine needs a weekly and proganil we need daily. Chloroquine and amodiaquine, which are discussed below, may also be used as the prophylactic. They will suppress all types of the malaria as they rapidly absorb, it's slowly excreted. Weekly dose is sufficient. This is the prophylactic treatment of the malaria. Some forms of the plasmodium resistance to the chloroquine and amodiaquine have been reported, but they are rare, occur and mainly in the far east and south America only. Then we see the suppressive drugs. These drugs or the schizantocytes inhibit the erythrocytic stage of the plasmodium. So, stop the clinical signs of the disease and prevent the symptoms. If schizantocytes are formed, these suppressive drugs are inhibit the that erythrocytic stage, inhibit that schizantocytes. They do not destroy the exoerythrocytic form and do not produce a residual cure, say with the Plasmodium falciparum, where there is no persistence exoerythrocytic form in the suppressive drug therapy. This persistence of the exoerythrocytic stage may be cause a relapse of a clinical malaria once the suppressive therapy is stopped. In that we use the quinine. Quinine is an alkaloid extracted from the cinchona, that is jesoot bark, has a long been known as cure for the malaria. Quinine, which is only one of the 20 or so alkaloid present in the bark, it is composed of a quinoline, quinoline group joined by a secondary alcohol. It is levorotatory, listed its isomer. Quinidine is a dextrorotatory and has a less antimalarial action. The main action of quinine is on the erythrocytic form of a plasmodium, but it is a less toxic. It is now used for those organism resistance to the other drug. It is also used by intravenous infusion in the treatment of the cerebral malaria. The toxic symptoms of the cinchona or cinchonism includes the tinnitus, deafness and optic nerves. These are the some adverse effect or side effect of the quinine. The quinine idiosyncrasy may be occur to cause the collapse, skin eruption, black water fever, that is hemoglobinuria due to the intramuscular hemolysis. Then we see the next drug, that is the chloroquine. This is the drug and the closely related to the amodiaquine. It is a 4-aminoquinoline derivative. It is very effective against the erythrocytic form of the plasmodium and rapidly control the clinical attack. It is immediately absorbed orally but slowly excreted. Being bound to the plasma protein, it accumulate in the liver. Chloroquine accumulated in the liver and exert an appreciable effect against the hepatic form of the etamoeba or entamoeba histolytica. Chloroquine is relatively well tolerated, though the chronic administration of a large dose, as may be given in the rheumatoid arthritis, may cause the reversible corneal octitis or progressive and irreversible retina pigmentation, and which may be damaged to the and lead to the blindness. Then next drug is mepacrine. The drug is a 9-aminoacridine derivative. It is very effective against the erythrocytic form of the most plasmodia. It may be given orally but can be cause gastric upset, central nervous depression or excitement. It also strain the skin yellow and it is not now used but may be effective in the treatment of the tapeworm. Then we see the drug producing radical cure. This drug eradicate both erythrocytic and pre-erythrocytic forms of the plasmodium. They may also inactivate the gamocytes also. Drug used in radical cure are the primaquine. It is a 8-aminoquinoline derivative, has both gametocidal action as well as destroying the exoerythrocytic forms, has a little schizantocide activity also, and it is used in the combination with the chloroquine. Primaquine is used with the combination with the chloroquine to attain the both pre-erythrocytic or exoerythrocytic forms and schizantocidal activity. Primaquine may cause the nausea, vomiting and abdominal pain. It may cause the methemoglobinemia and intravascular hemolysis, especially in the dark skin races due to the genetically determined lack of the glucose 6 phosphate dehydrogenase. This is the enzyme, glucose 6 phosphate dehydrogenase enzyme, which make a red cell fragile. Then the pamaquine. This is also an 8-aminoquinoline derivative, but more toxic than the primaquine or primaquine, which has largely replaced it. We see the drugs effective in the and which are effective against which type of the form of the malaria. 8-aminoquinoline derivatives, example of it, primaquine and to the lesser extent pyrimethamine. These drugs are effective against primarily tissue schizonts or primarily exoerythrocytic stage. Then 4-aminoquinoline drugs, these are effective against the erythrocytic forms. And acridine derivatives, these are effective against the rapid acting against erythrocytic forms. Then we reach towards the summary. In this session, we cover the what is meant by chemotherapy of malaria, life cycle of malaria protozoa, then drug producing casual prophylaxis, prophylactic measures in the malaria. We see the suppressive drugs, drugs producing radical cure and its adverse action. Thank you very much for attending this session.